Hi guys, welcome back to another video, and this is an Elementor tutorial. And in this tutorial you will learn how to add video on scroll. So imagine you have a video on your website and it plays when you scroll down and it goes rewind when you scroll up. So that's the feature which we'll be adding on the Elementor website without using any plugin. It's a free feature which you will learn through this video. So make sure to watch the complete video till the end, where you will learn how to add video on scroll, which gonna add a beautiful UI enhanced video on your Elementor website. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel, which will help us create more valuable content for you guys. And heading over to my co-host Nida Sheikh, who will teach you how to add video on scroll.
Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. Welcome back to another tutorial video. In this video, I'll show you how you can play a video on scroll in Elementor. What happens is, when you add a scrolling video sequence in Elementor, it can make your WordPress website look unique and interesting. And so users stay engaged and keep coming back. So I won't waste time and tell you quickly how you can make the scroll trigger. First of all, we'll add a new page here. Click pages and add a new page here. Okay, now first of all, I'll quickly make a dummy header here. So we'll add a two column structure, one for the logo and one for the menu. So let's just add an image widget first here, and we'll quickly search for a logo. We'll add a white logo here because our background needs to be a bit darker. Okay, so let's add a menu now. We'll add a menu widget. Now let's just sort it out. We'll give it some styling. My first container needs to be 25% and this container, it needs to be 75%. Yes. Okay, we'll align this container to the end and this one's to the end. Okay, what I want is I need to change its color to white as well, because our logo is in white, so I think white looks more beautiful. I know it's not visible right now, but once we are done with adding the video, it will be visible. Okay, if you want, you can change its size as well. Let's lower its size. Okay, let's change its width to bits. Smaller and align it to the left. Okay, we'll do the rest afterwards once it's sorted. Okay, now what I'll do is I'll add this container here, and we'll add a content width to full width, min height to VH first, and then I'll make it 100. Okay, we have some padding here, you guys can see. Let's go to advanced and remove the padding here. Okay, this is done. Coming towards adding the video here, I'll add a video from my left hand side. From my left hand side, you guys can see the source option. Instead of YouTube, I want it to be self-hosted. Yes. Okay, let's add the video here. Let me see which video. Okay, this looks good. Let me show you guys what video I have added here. So see, this is the video. So this is an IT related website. IT, we provide IT services. So I think this video is pretty good. Make sure your video is not too big. Otherwise we can't use that video. It won't be uploaded. Okay, now this is done. When we scroll down, you guys can see there's a mute option. Yes, we need to mute it first. Okay, we have the player control. This is the player control. I want to hide the player control now. Okay, this part is done. Now you guys can see you cannot play the video. This is done. Now you guys can see this white background doesn't look good. So for that, the topmost container we'll choose. We'll go to advanced from our left hand side. You guys can see the margin option. We want the bottom margin to be minus big value. Now you guys can see that this logo is not visible. This is because we need to increase the Z index value to a high number. Okay, so we'll choose the image here and we'll go to advanced. Scroll down more and you guys can see the Z index value. Let's make it a high number so my logo is visible. Now it looks pretty cool. You guys can see, but it won't work because we need to add a code here. Okay, for that purpose, what I want is I need to open the dashboard again. Okay, let's log in again here in the new tab. Okay, here in Elementor, you guys can see the custom code option from your left hand side. Click add new. Okay, we'll name it as play video on scroll. And here I'll add a code here, which I'll also mention in the description below so that you guys can copy paste it. Okay, now let's paste the code here and let's click. We don't want it for the entire site, so we will make it for the singular. We'll add pages here. Now type the name of the page, which play video on scroll. Okay, so I've added the page here, 2143, and this is the right number. Okay, now we'll click update here. The video scroll code is added. Let's preview and see if my video is working or not. Okay, let's get it loaded first, and yes, the video is working, but it's not working properly. This is because we need to do some changes. Okay, now what I'll do is I'll make something below this video so that we can scroll easily. Okay, just making a dummy templates very quickly. So first one is for the image here, and this one is for the heading, some text. Okay, and we can make some amendments here. Let's add an image here. Okay, the image is inserted. Now let's sort it out. Let's make it in the center. Okay, and let's give it a background, nice background here. Okay, let's give it a background color. Okay, looks nice. We can make it to black color. Okay, let's make it black and this black as well. Okay, done. This is done. Now what I want to do is I'll open navigator here, the container. Okay, what else we need to do? The container in which we have the video, we need to go to advanced and we'll scroll down, and here you guys can see the motion effect option. Here you need to make this sticky from the top. Okay, and when you scroll down here, you guys can see stain column option. This needs to be a yes. Okay, this is done. This container, when we go to layouts here, you guys can see a Z index option. All you need to do is you need to lower the Z index of this container and hide the Z index of the container which we have added below here, so that when we scroll, the other containers are visible as well. Let's make it one. Okay, cool, this is done. Let's click update and see if it's working properly or not. Okay, now let's scroll. When I scroll down, okay, let's get it loaded first. When I scroll, this is how it looks. Looks so beautiful here. A person is typing on a laptop and it comes back to its original position. And again, I hope you like this tutorial. If you want more such videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, hit the like button and comment below so that I can make more such videos for you.